Hello there. This is my unusual 3D printer design. It's called Marionette. Printing a toy chameleon. This 3D printer does not use any linear rails. For the XY axis, it uses a glass plate on which rides a slider. It gets pulled around by four ropes using two motors. Here's one rope getting wound onto the winch, and it winds a nice helical spiral. Same thing happens on the other winch, and on the winches closer to the camera, same thing. And to move the bed up and down, there's six ropes that all driven together by this non-linear pulley. Got googly eyes. From the linear side of the pulley comes a rope that goes to a spring and a regular belt that does the actual Z movement. The movement is linear in terms of the motor rotation. Nothing strange happens in software. The only weird thing here is that instead of using linear rails, it uses six ropes. Let's see how it's printing. The bed is not heated yet, been having some trouble with that. Prints lift off a little bit sometimes. Just a regular bounding setup for the plastic pushing. It just pushes the plastic down the bounding tube into the print head. Let's look more at the mechanism on the back of the printer. So, here's a motor which drives rope that goes straight to the print head. And there was a rope going to this mechanism here. This is basically the mechanical opposite of the mechanism below. Where the mechanism below has ropes in tension, the mechanism above has sticks in compression. It transfers force from the two motors to the two unmotorized shafts here and here, and maintains tension on the ropes no matter where the print head goes. Not a trivial problem, because the sum of the lengths of the cables to the print head does not stay constant. If you just pass the cables behind, it's not gonna work. You have to have some kind of non-linear mechanism matched to the mechanism below. Here's the adjustment. It's just guitar tuners. They allow you to line everything up perfectly. You just line up the top and the bottom mechanisms, both to the center. The mechanism in the back is now 3D printed. It would be a lot better to make it out of metal. But it's good enough. With metal it could be smaller, but the smaller it is, the greater the forces, so this is about as small as I can make it with 3D printed parts. Let's look again at how it's printing. Ropes are angled, that keeps the print head pushed into the glass. And it also winds perfect helices on the winches. You can see really neat. I love how it does that. Out through the movement, a perfect helix without having to have any guide, channel, or anything like that. Now let's, on the top, it just simply kind of winds by itself. Not a problem. Yeah, let's get back to the Z mechanism. The basic idea is that the anglet cables provide a 6-dof constraint. For that, they can't all be parallel to movement, they have to be at an angle to the movement. Why this works is that all 6 cables are equal lengths, and that corresponds to straight flat movement. Pairs of cables come here and get joined into 3 single cables. Then the 3 single cables come up there and get joined into 1 cable that winds into this nonlinear winch. The winch shape is calculated based on the formula for the length of the cables depending on z. That's simply square root of position squared plus constant. It's basically Pythagoras theorem. Simply, yeah, it's really, in mathematics might be complicated, but the mechanism is very simple. This is just a reduction drive here. Has a big pulley, a small pulley, and another small pulley you can't really see, and just drives the belt that goes to the bottom of the frame. There is a spring. The reason there has to be a spring is that otherwise it would be over constrained, because there's 6 cables and 1 belt, that's 1 degree over constraint. Because there's only 6-dof constraint needed. Now it's done with the first layer and sprinting much faster, as you can see. I was sprinting the first layer slow to avoid it lifting too much. Oh no, it is coming off the bed a little bit. I really need to add a heated bed to it next. One big issue with this build is that the slider can sometimes rattle on the glass. That's not good at all. It limits maximum speed acceleration a bit, because if it's banging, that's gonna show up as artifacts. Right now it is working just fine too. I think I should use an air bearing instead of the slider, a vacuum preloaded air bearing, because that would be able to stick to the glass better. There's a limit of how hard I can push it up using just anglet ropes. Yeah, that's about it. This is a finished chameleon. Thanks for watching and see you next time.